morning to all of you. Today we are going to see how we are going to connect Android Studio with the Firebase. Now the Firebase, it is a database given by the Google, and it is a NoSQL database, so it is an online database. So we are going to check how we are going to use this Firebase database for email authentication and how we are going to create a database in a Firebase. So for that we require a Google Cloud also. So we'll see one by one how we are going to connect with the Firebase. Now, whenever you want to do any connection with the Firebase, I'm taking one simple example. So the example is, of course, email verification. We have to give the email name and the password, and if it is correct, it is going to check online and it is going to give the result, or it is going to go in the next screen. So for that, simply we have created one XML file, that is activity main. So inside this XML, we have created one text box for the email and second for the password. Now this email and password, this is going to store in a Firebase database. So this is verification, it is done by the Firebase. So when we see this window, so simply we have created one, that is email address text box, second is password text box, and third that's the register button, and last we have taken a progress bar. So this is a progress bar. So progress bar we have used for the waiting purpose, so that it is going to connect online, and whenever it is going to connect, till the response comes, it is going to wait that position, means it is going to do the progress or waiting bar, that is called as progress bar. So this was about the screen. Screen is very simple. We have taken just username and password, email address and password, and that we want to do the verification. Now we see the Java code. Now in the Java code, of course, what we have done, the two text boxes we have initialized, and the button we have initialized, and the progress bar. So whatever the controls we have used, that is we have initialized over here. Now whenever you want to do the email verification, for that purpose we need one class of the Firebase. That class is nothing but this Firebase auth. So this class is needed. This class is present in the com.google.firebase.auth.firebaseauth. So this is the required class, or this is required library, or this is required package. So the class present is Firebase auth, and the object is fauth. Now how we have to initialize this class? Now here fauth, the object of the Firebase authentication, is equal to firebase.getInstance. So we have to get the instance of a class Firebase auth. So this is the first task we want to first do the authentication. Now whenever you want to do, whenever we want to use a Firebase, first go in the tools and click on the Firebase. So when you click on the Firebase, it is going to connect with, and we have to click on the authentication. Now when you click on the authentication, you have to click on email and password authentication. Now our first step is connect your app to Firebase. So first step, we have to connect with the Firebase. So click on over here. My app is already connected. So if you are doing first time, first click on the connect your app to Firebase. When you click over here, some libraries get installed, and the checkbox, this check mark is done, that is connected. So the first thing, whenever you are going to connect with the Firebase, first you want to connect with the Firebase database. So you have to connect it online. This is the first thing. Second, add Firebase authentication to your app. Now here we want to click. When you click on the add Firebase authentication to your app, then it is going to install the libraries required for the Firebase. So these two steps are very important. Number one, for the connect your app to Firebase, and number second, add Firebase authentication to your app. Now by using this this assistance, or by using this task or step, all the libraries needed for the Firebase is get installed automatic. So when it is installed automatic, you can check in the Gradle also. So com.google.gms.google/services, it is on. Okay. Now here, when you open this dependencies, when you open the build.gradle file, that is Gradle file, all the dependencies are present for a particular app in the Gradle file. So when you check the Gradle file, you will get what are the dependencies are there, it is installed. So here you can check com.google.firebase:firebase-17.2.2, this is the version. And again Firestore version for 21.4.2. So these are going to be added. So these are the two important steps we have to do. Now we are going to check the Java code. Now this is the Java code. This is the initialization we have to do. Now after that, you can check whether the username and password is empty or not. So email, I'm taking string, that is email 1 and password 1 as username.getText.toString.trim. These two sentences already we have done with it. Next, we have to check whether the text box is empty or not. Now how we are going to check it? By using textutils class. So android.text.textutils, this is the package you want to import, android.text. Now when you import it, you will get a class textutils. Now textutils.isEmpty, email, and textutils.isEmpty, password. So you are going to check whether username password is null or not. If it is null, it is going to give the error. Now here you can do another thing also. For the password, the password should be strong. So password should be at least 6 characters, and password should contain at least one uppercase character and one special case character. So that kind of validation also you can do. Otherwise you can do for the password length, at least it should be 6 character. So you can use a length utility or a length property function of the string, and you can check over here if the password is less than 6 character, it is going to give the error or the toast message that please enter password more than 6 characters. So you can another add the condition over here. Now the next thing. Now here for it is object. Now you are calling the method create user with email and password. So you are going to create user with email and password. We are passing two values, one that is email and second is password. After that we have to call a method add on complete listener. Now when you call add on complete listener, it is going to implement interface on implement on complement listener auth result. Now here the method we have to override, that is public void on complete. So add that null task auth result and task. Now if the task dot is successful, if it is successful, then the progress bar becomes invisible and toast message is that added user has added successfully, or you can write over as user has added successfully, user has added successfully. So it is for you are going to create the user. So now we know how to run it. Now first thing is that when I click on the Firebase, you have to click first on the authentication. When you click on over here, you will come to the Firebase. Now this is the window of the Firebase. From here we have to go at the console, go to console. Before that one window comes, that is for the login. So with your with your Google or with your Gmail account, you have to do the login. After that, this is the demo I have already created project. Now click on the authentication. Now first step is that we have to click on the authentication. Now once you click on authentication, you will get a window like this. Now already we have done 2-3 accounts, so my user is displayed over here. For you, if it is a first time, then it will be a blank. Now click on the sign in method. Now once you click on the sign in method, the new window will comes. Now this is a very important task. You have to click on email or a password and it should be enabled. By default it is disabled. So we have to click over here, and here we have to make the enable. So by default it is disabled. If you are working first time, it should be enabled. Now click on the save. I'm going to cancel it because already I have saved it. So this is a very important step. If it is not, then your application is not going to use a Firebee database. So this is a very important thing. Now you have to run the program. Now this is a very simple step. First, now the thing is that just we have to call a method create user with email and password. Here we have to give email and a password, and add on complete listener we have to call this method, and on complete listener this is the interface you have to call it. After that we have to override a method on complete, so this automatically comes. And after that, if the task, so this is the object, task dot is successful, that means the user has created successfully, then I want to display toast message. So I have taken user has created successfully. Now this is the main activity. Now I'm going at Android manifest file. Now here I want to call the main activity. Now I'm going to run it. Now this will be the output of the screen. Just we have created two text box and one button. From here we have to give the values. Now suppose I'm giving a password less than 6 characters, then it is going to give the error at the logcat. I will show that error also. So suppose I'm giving username as anilkumar@gmail.com, and the password I'm giving as a test, and I'm clicking on the register. Now it is going to wait because it is going to connect to the Firebee database. Now you can see in the logcat also. It will take some time, it depends on the net connection also, how fast net connection is. So once you connect with Google, so when I'm giving username as or email as anilkumar@gmail.com and password as test, and when I click on the register, the app is not going to register because it is not 6 characters. So if you check in the logcat also, you will get that kind of warning or that kind of error also. So here I'm not finding that, but if you see logcat, okay, so log.d, if you type over here log.d, and you can check the logcat also. So when you give that kind of password and when you check over here, you will see that the user has not yet created. So here only 2 users. Now suppose I want to give password as test exclamation symbol 123, so it is more than 6 characters. So when I click on the register, here user has created added successfully, you will get a pop-up message over here or the toast message over here. Now I'm going to cross check at the website, that is Firebase website. When you click or when you refresh it, now see anilkumar@gmail.com, this website has user has created. So this user has created just now. You can check out for another user also. Suppose I want to give another email and password. So suppose I'm giving email as Prashant Patil, okay, @gmail.com. And I'm keeping password same as it is. So when you click on the register, the user has added successfully. You can cross check in a Firebase. Now see, Prashant Patil has added now. So like this, you can you can add users and you can do the authentication from that also. So this was about how you are going to use Firebase or how you are going to connect Android app with the Firebase. Now suppose I want to verify it. Okay, how means if the username password is correct, then I want to go at the next screen, or then I want to display the toast message that user is exist or user password is correct. So for that again, I'm going to create another screen. Now here I have created one screen for the login. Now simply what I want to do, I want to just cross check whether username password is exist or not. So the class is Firebase auth, object is fauth, and fauth is equal to firebase.get instance. So this was same as the previous one. I have created one text box for the username, one for the password, and one button for the submit. Now you can check over here also. So this was one text box, another text box, and submit button. And this is activity underscore login. So this is the login Java code. I'm getting username and password. I'm checking whether it is empty or not. After that, I want to call a method sign in with email and password. So this method is important. You have to call a method sign in with email and password. You have to give username, that is email, and a password. And we have to call add on complete listener. Now the interface we want to implement, that is on complete listener auth result. Now here the method we want to implement, that is on complete. The task is the task dot is successful. If username password is exist and it is successful, then I want to display login successful. You can go for the next screen also by using intent class. Now already we have seen how to go from one screen to another screen. If you don't know, you can check out the previous videos also. In the first or second video, we have seen how we are going to transfer from one screen to another. So here either you can display a toast message, otherwise you can go to the next screen. If is the password or is not exist, we have to show the error. Now let's check by running the program. The task is login.java. So in the Android manifest, I'm going to run that file. So in the main activity, I'm giving here as a login. So here I'm writing as a main activity. Now I want to run the application. Now this is a simple screen of this is the simple output. Here we have to provide username and password, and you have to check it. So simply I'm giving username as a test, and password is also test, and click on the submit. You will get error because test username and password test does not exist. Now recently we have created two users, one that is prashantpatil@gmail.com and anilkumar@gmail.com. So just check for that. So username is anilkumar@gmail.com. And I'm writing password as test exclamation symbol 123. Now when you click over here, you'll get login successful. That means the email and password has verified successfully. Also you can send a message also over here, but that's again another task. So like this you can use a Firebase database for authentication purpose, for email and password authentication. So this was about the how we are going to use a Firebase. So this is very basic. Again, Firebase is a NoSQL database. So again, you can use a Firebase for a database creation also. So in the next session, we will see how we are going to create a database and how we are going to store the data. Basically, it is going to use a JSON format for storing the data. So if you have any doubts, any questions about the Firebase database or about the how we are going to connect Firebase with the Android Studio, you can put on the comments. So this was end of session. Thank you.